Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Kicking off this video, we have the launch of GPS-3 SV05 on Thursday. This is the first flight of a national security payload on a flight-proven booster.
Zero, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go GPS.
The booster which launched B1062 then landed successfully for the second time and the drone ship just read the instructions.
What a beautiful view of that first stage landing.
I want to share an article as SpaceX responded to the Viasat fiasco where they are trying to prevent the Starlink network expansion. It says, SpaceX has accused Viasat of attempting a transparent bid to co-opt the National Environmental Policy Act and the procedure for extraordinary stay relief as weapons of commercial warfare. Heading over to Boca Chica, some major roadworks are currently going on at the launch site. As mentioned last week, they stacked the fifth level of the integration tower. A new vehicle integration tower segment was rolled out, with this being level 6. Then, at the propellant production site, they are working on the next tower segment. Also at this location is the next cryo tank shell, as well as others being constructed. The liquid oxygen distiller was recently painted white. There was an interesting tweet posted about some land SpaceX has purchased. It says, SpaceX recently closed on the purchase of Macy's Gun Shop and Range off of a road on the way to Starbase. Sources close to the deal have indicated that this location will be the Raptor facility and possible uses may include repair, rebuild and testing of rocket engines. That super heavy section with holes we saw last episode is an upper stack and has been sleeved with its dome. With regards to the unauthorized Starship launch in December, the FAA has defended SpaceX. In this CNBC article, it says, we would not have cleared them to start flight operations again had I not been confident they had modified their procedures effectively and addressed the safety culture issues that we saw. Somebody called Ryan McDonald posted on Twitter with a cool picture showing the Starship timeline from start to now. There's also what we can hope to expect coming up with SN20 and BN2 performing the orbital flight. A new ground support equipment tank upper bulkhead stack was spotted outside. SN16 was moved from the high bay to be put on display. Look at this great shot of both SN15 and SN16. There was a Teslarati tweet about an article saying SpaceX retires brand new Starship to focus on orbital launch build-up. Musk responded with, we might use SN16 on a hypersonic flight test. Here's Super Heavy booster number 2 in the high bay. The Super Heavy BN2.1 test tank performed some further cryo testing on Thursday. To finish up our Sunday video, as usual, we have the Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. With Mary currently away, both Jack Beyer and Brady Keniston have been out in Boca Chica filming the amazing content, so thanks to both of them. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their videos, livestreams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.